Good morning. Thank you for coming. I'm just going to touch briefly on the education budget. Myself, Senator Tom, Senator Hill, Senator Fain, we've been working in a bipartisan way this entire session to make sure that we continue to improve the education system. With the current 1.1 budget hole, one of the things we want to make sure was we do as little harm or no harm to the education system as possible. We were very disappointed with the House budget when they came out and shifted $404 million into next year, leaving a big hole there. And importantly, adding insult to injury, they cut the levy lid from 28% to 24%, as well as the levy equalization payment from 14 to 12%, adding another $400 million hole next year. Our first budget that you saw when we came out with it, we identified $44 million in cuts to education in the K-12 system. These were cuts that myself, Senator McAuliffe, Senator Ide, and Senator Rolfes had identified back in December as part of a bipartisan working group to do the least harm to the education system. They were not part of basic education. They were not part in the classroom. The good news was the House came back, as you saw on the last day, and they took away the levy lids, which is what my district and everybody in the education committee was jumping up and down about. So that was a good move. They still have a $330 million one-time shift into next year, which leaves a $330 million hole that we've got to start filling, right? So when we went back and we worked over the last couple weeks, how do we hold harmless? And as you can see here, we've gone back in and made no cuts to education, right? We've funded the teacher evaluation bill, which was, again, a great step forward in a bipartisan manner. We've also added in the urban transformation zones with Representative Pettigrew, as well as charter schools. And part of this goes back to a commitment Rodney Tom and myself, Eric Pettigrew, Bruce Danmeyer made this summer of we have 50% of children in fourth grade in communities of color in high poverty that are reading below grade level, right? We're losing an entire generation of kids. We know the problem. Everybody's jumping up and down about charters. Representative Pettigrew's got a very interesting idea here with these urban transformation zones. We're trying to solve that problem, right? Putting more money into a system and expecting different results is the ultimate definition of insanity. So what we're doing with this budget today, holding all the education current system harmless, making sure we're not in a hole when we start next year, as well as identifying those chronically underperforming schools that we know have a problem in trying to address that. I'll look forward to your questions at the end. Thank you.